Welcome to another iScaf tutorial. In the version of iScaf released around August 2016, we have some subtle but very good improvements to the Edit Plan, Edit Wall Details options, as well as the Bay Labeling options. Firstly, there is the Edit Plan option, which is shown on this toolbar right here, on this icon, where we can click on Edit Plan. Then we have this 1-2-3 icon here, which is the Bay Labeling option. Let's go into the Bay Labeling option first. So as a default, you will just see the bay length on the screen, but we can actually set the system to show the bay width, and we can turn off bay numbering. We can also show the actual stages, that is, allocating the stages for the bays, and we can show the bay height as well. So we turn those two options on and we click OK. As you can see, now we have labelling of the heights of all the bays, and we have the labelling of the width of the bays as well. So let's go into that menu again, because the other thing we can see is that the bay height can also represent the top deck minus the bottom deck. Which means that if we take into account sloping ground or some scaffold that sits high on a slab, it's possible to have a scaffold with the top deck at 40 foot, but the actual height of the scaffold could be much less than that because of the higher slope or slab, for example. So that's what this checkbox here is for, to change the label height as the top deck minus the bottom deck, which is the actual height of the scaffold itself. The other option we'll look at is the Edit Plan. So when we click on the Edit Plan option, you'll see that the cursor changes from a cross to a square box. So from here, we can click on any bay and we can edit the wall properties. As we can see, the options that we have are add properties, where we can add bracing and handrails and so on. And then we have the normal add option, where you can add bay ladders and stairs. If we click on edit wall details, which is the first option here, it will show a box that allows us to change the height of any scaffold and change the properties and details of any particular bay. So if we say apply to selection, it'll mean that we can change the properties of whatever we select. This can be individual bays, or if we click on apply to wall, this means that this whole run of scaffold will have that. So one good example is we can very quickly click on the bay width and say, well, let's just make this 5 foot wide instead, and click apply to wall, and straight away it will allocate and make the wall wider. So if we go back into this again, and we go to edit wall details again, we can also change the side bracket width, or we can completely remove the side brackets from the drawing. So we can do that and change it to just a one board side bracket, and click apply to wall, and you can see that immediately changes the scaffold to have one board side brackets. Now let's illustrate what we can achieve here in this example. The top lift height is 40 feet for this scaffold, which is right here at the top lift here. And the effective height of the jacks, just in this position here, has been set at this elevation at 22 feet. So then we can see the actual effective height from here to here is 18 feet. So that means we now know the effective height of the scaffold for these three bays here. The next option we'll look at is how you can also be in this edit wall or edit scaffold, edit plan option and go back into edit wall details. And this is what we mean by having the ability to change the top and the bottom. So the top represents the top deck or top lift. So that's the top lift there. And we can change the bottom so that the jacks actually sit higher up in elevation. So in other words, we're catering for some stepping up of the scaffold or stepping onto a slab or simulating a slope. So we can actually change this to say something like 22 feet, and instead of applying it to the whole wall, we can just apply it to a window. So we click on apply to selection and then just window and change these few bays here in the middle to reflect that new height. So we select those bays and right click, and instantly the changes are made to the scaffold. So if we turn the bay labelling back on and we show the height of the scaffold, so we go by height there and we click OK on that, then we get our labelling back and we can see there, because we've changed the height of the scaffold, it is now 18 foot high instead of 40 foot high at those points. So now when we build in 3D, we can actually see how this is represented. And let's change our view to look at it from a different angle. As we can see there, we have changed the height of the scaffold at that particular point. So that's the bay labelling and edit wall option in iScaf 2016.